die, we are not alike. But you don't shine when they hit the lights. I don't make myself bleed for this life in these kind of nights. You just okay, but I'm kind of nice. Yeah, I said it's game time. Baby, I said it's game time. Feel the pain in my voice just right now. Yeah, this is game time. Come and ride with a winner. I said it's game time. Yeah, I said it's game time.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another installment of Broken Arrow Ladies Tigers Basketball. I am joined alongside here Tiffany Jones and on the sideline, Madison Dildine. Tiffany, it is so great to be here tonight, and I'm just excited for this game.
Yeah, first game of 2022. Breaking off, we got a new look in the gym for all of our viewers at home. We called it Extreme Makeover Gym Edition, courtesy of some of our boys' coaches as they were updating the progress. But the floor looks great, so we're very thankful for the guys that worked on that and the school system that supports athletics, obviously. But, man, the facility looks really nice tonight, and that's be a great way to open up. We've got a top matchup in 6A girls tonight between Bixby and Lady Tigers.
And the Lady Tigers last played Bixby on December 10th. They lost in a close one, 61-56, and the game started off, they were down 19 points, and they, you know, came back on them, and they almost completed the comeback, but as Coach Coffey's players, you know, they lost gas, but, you know, I think they're better prepared tonight, especially when you have already played a team.
Sure, you can scout, but being on the court against somebody having a game, you learn a lot. They had one of their key players that was out last game. But we had a great effort. I tell you what, it's, you know, takeaways, even when you lose a game like that, is you got a big hole. We were down big, and we fought back, came back, and had a chance to win the game. Just execution late, and those are learning opportunities. And that's what I expect, is that those girls have learned from those things. Coach Coffey and his staff have really spent time on that. And this Bixby team has a lot of experience, and sometimes – the only way to get experience is to be out there on the court. And so we got some valuable experience last time we played them, and we're going to continue to improve on our on-court decision-making and things like that. We're just going to keep getting better and better.
And Bixby has a lot of size. Elisa Nielsen is a 6-foot junior, and then Meredith May is 6'3" junior. So...
yeah, two players with significant size, which can cause – that's a tough matchup for a lot of teams. And they've got a group of core players that have been playing since they were freshmen at the varsity level. And so they can create some size matchups, just because, especially when you've got a 6'3" player that can play outside, she can shoot outside. I mean, those are hard to come by in girls basketball, 6-footers that can play in and out. And so – matchup problems, yes, but then we've got advantages on our end. We've got some athleticism that's really hard to match up with, too. So it's going to be an interesting matchup at several different positions tonight.
And Broken Arrow being with Talaya Jones and Mackenzie Mathurin, both who can rebound the ball. And Mackenzie Mathurin almost, you know, averaging 11.6 points per game, 6.4 rebounds, and just 10 assists. And 2 steals and 2 blocks, so she is definitely a beast on the defensive end. And
you love to have players that fill up the stat lines. Get assists, cause turnovers, get deflections, rebounding. I mean, that's part of being a complete player, is being able to put stats in every line. You like to miss the turnover line, but everything else you want to put stats in. And so she's just going to continue to improve at this level, being a freshman. We've got youth, obviously, on our side also, but we're going to just keep getting better and better. And so I love the different matchups tonight. It's going to be a chess match between Coach Coffey and Coach Thomas, both very well-respected coaches in the game. And so it's going to be it's a great opportunity for us tonight to go out and get a big win.
And you know, tonight, blocking out Alyssa Nielsen is going to be a tough task. But if anyone can do it, you know, I think Grace Pippett can do it. But with her size and, you know, her rebounding ability. And, yeah, we just definitely got to block out because...
It's great. I know Madison Dildine's joining us from the sidelines tonight. 94 feet of basketball. So, Madison, what are you looking forward to tonight?
Yeah, guys, I think that this is going to be a great matchup. You know, they're going to have a tough stretch of conference games going into next week. But Coach Coffey said earlier that they're going to learn a lot about their team because of that tough stretch of conference play, guys.
We will enjoy being at have a home game tonight, and then we're going to be on the road for a little bit. But tonight, breaking in the new look of the gym is exciting for Broken Arrow, and I think we are getting close to being able to have the national anthem and have the starting lineups.
Starting lineups. There goes Gentry Baldwin, 5'6 guard. Bryn Daniel coming out, 5'8 freshman. We have Gracie Wardley coming out, 5'9 guard. And then Alyssa Nielsen coming out for them, 6'.
Tina Thomas.
Arrows getting ready to introduce their starting lineups.
And now, starting for your home standing, Brooks and Arrow Tigers. Starting tonight, 5'10" sophomore. Number 10, Talia Jones.
Talia Jones, a 5'10" senior coming in.
5'10" junior, number 15, Grace Pippett.
Race Pippett coming in, a 5'10" junior.
5'11" junior, number 22, Tanea Howard.
Tanea Howard, 5'11" junior.
5'10" senior, number 23,
Anissa Herrera, 5'8" senior coming in. And Mackenzie Mathurin, the freshman, 5'10" coming in. Broken Arrow 3-2. Bixby is 6-2 as we get ready to begin the tip.
You know, our size, we do have size. It's not in the form of six-footers, but we do have several that are 5'10", and that can be matchup problems. Once again, our athleticism, controlling tempo is going to be important for us tonight, and, you know, taking care of the basketball, not letting them have wide-open three-pointers because they can shoot the three.
And Alyssa Nielsen had 25 points in her last meeting. And we definitely just got to stop her from shooting the mid-range because that is her go-to shot. So we definitely do not want her shooting all the middies. But she is also the best at blocking out and putting it back up. So as we get ready here, it's like Tanea Howard will tip off. She will tip off against Meredith Mays.
I think we had a little, maybe a technical issue with one of our officials that just left the court. We'll be waiting for her to come back. Looks like there might have been a whistle issue. So
definitely do not want that.
Talked to Talia today around school. Some of the girls I saw, and they were excited to be back and have school today and a big game tonight. So they were kind of a big day for them, especially the seniors, their last first day. So I see our third officials back.
And Howard wins the tip, and Mathurin will start the game. Talia Jones will pass to Herrera. Grace Pippett has it at the wing. Grace Pippett driving in. Grace Pippett goes right up with it. No good. But she gets it right out to Talia Jones. Great rebound from Grace Pippett. Right back to Mathurin. Mathurin dribbling around. And Mathurin just gets it ripped. And Bryn Daniel has it, but she passes right back to, looks like, sorry, Baldwin. Baldwin up with the floater, and no good. Rebound. And they call a jump ball there. Mathurin and Mays getting into the mix of it. Baldwin will pass in. And she will pass right to Mays. And Mays will go right up with it. What a shot from Mays. Mathurin taking it up the court once again. Mathurin has Baldwin on her. The pass to Herrera. Herrera looking around. Herrera with the crossover, no good. Howard has it at the top. Howard will drive. Howard will get it right back out to Jones. Jones will size up. And Jones, and it looks to be a reach-in foul. Looks like it was on Mays.
Well, good job by Talay, seeing that defensively she was out of position and drawing the contact.
Mathurin has it up top again. Baldwin guarding Mathurin. Mathurin the pass to Pippett. She will get it to Mathurin. Mathurin will drive. Mathurin will goes up at it, and it's blocked by Baldwin. Howard right back up. Howard in the middle. And it was a good effort from Howard. Baldwin, the pass to Nielsen, and
Yeah, that's adjusting as a player when you realize you've got a 6'3 girl in the middle. You got to change a little bit about what you do. You still have to be aggressive.
Daniel has it in the corner, tries to get out. She throws a bounce pass, and it is taken away. Talia Jones has it. Talia Jones will take it up the court. She has Wardley on her. Now Mathurin has it again. Talia Jones popping out. Talia Jones will pass to Howard. Howard up, 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 no good. And Baldwin will take it up the floor. Baldwin will pass to Mays. Mays the pass to, no good for that. Three by Baldwin is no good. Talia Jones will take it up. Mathurin has it. And Grace Pippett signaled a screen, but Mathurin said no, and she goes right up with it.
You know, good recognition for her. She's got a size advantage there, so.
And what a steal from Talia Jones. Talia Jones, the pass to Mathurin. They got numbers. Talia Jones, and she just could not finish there.
Getting some good looks inside. They're going to start falling.
It goes Baldwin, the pass to Mays. Mays with the step back three. No good. Mathurin has it. Mathurin will take it up the court. And she will get a screen from Howard. Mathurin looking to create some offense here. Howard will get it to Herrera. Herrera thinking about it. And the cutting to Leia Jones, and it is no good.
So, you know, the right read, Talia's got a, she's back cutting when someone overplays out in the passing lane, so good read, we just didn't execute the pass and the cut.
Baldwin will take it up the floor. And then she gets it to Daniel, who's in the corner, and Herrera knocks it right out of her hands. Baldwin would check it up, or pass in, sorry. Daniel, the pass to, looks like Mays with the three. Or sorry, Warnley.
Yeah.
And Mathurin will take it up the floor once again. She has Baldwin on her. Mathurin will get it to Howard. Howard will drive, and like to be a possible.
Called it on Baldwin on the block, on the drive there, so.
Mathurin will pass in. She passes it to Pippett. Pippett in the corner. Mathurin. And Mathurin will cross over. Mathurin with the left hand. No good. Rebound, Nielsen. She will get it straight to Baldwin. There goes Nielsen again. Baldwin has it up top. There goes Warnley. Almost deflects a turnover for Talia Jones. And there goes, no good, and it was Daniel with the three.
We're gonna get Tanaya Howard on the push there on the rebound. She was trying to make good contact, but got her hands out, a little shove.
Over the back there. Baldwin will pass it in. She'll get it straight to Mays. Mays will go up with it, no good. Rebound Thurin, Mithurin, sorry. Thurin will take it up the floor. Thurin has Baldwin on her. She gets a screen from Pippett. Another screen from Herrera. Pippett will try to drive. Pippett will go up with the floater. No good. Talia Jones has it. Talia Jones will shoot the corner three. No good. And Baldwin will take it up the floor. She will get it right to Warnley. And they're just looking to get something here. Baldwin has it up top. She will pass to Daniel. Daniel in the Daniel in the post, and it's no good by Mays. Looks like a turnover.
Yeah, just a turnover on an outlet pass. Coach Frustrating for Coach Coffee, I know.
Mm-hmm.
Did a great job, got a stop, and then just a turnover right back at him.
Broken Arrow's been trying to push the pace already this game, and Daniel has it. She will get the ball to Mornley. Right back to Daniel, to Baldwin. And what a shot, and that is good for Daniel. She just pops out at the wing. Mathurin will take the ball up the floor. Mathurin has Baldwin on her. Mathurin to Leia Jones in the corner. Screen from Herrera, and she tries to do a little pick and roll there, but it ends up being a pick and pop. No good. And up with it was Taryn Jacobs, I believe. Mathurin on Baldwin once again. Baldwin looking. The pass to Daniel. And right there, Warnley just hits a three. And Mathurin will take it up the floor. Pass to Talia Jones in the corner. Mathurin popping out to the corner. Mathurin moving everywhere, and she drives it in, and she just throws a turnover there. And she will get it right to Nielsen. Nielsen who goes up with it, and that is a shooting foul. Nielsen would take two at the charity stripe.
Officials confirm to make sure they've got.
Oh, and she they overturn it to a travel.
That was going to be a close call there. See if they're going to call the contact first or the travel. But we'll take that.
And it looks like Hallie Kitchen checking in for Anissa Herrera. Hallie Kitchen looking to get some action. And Hallie Kitchen has it, and she gets it right to Talia Jones. Jones. She will get it right back to Pippett. Pippett, the pass inside to Jacobs, and they call a jump ball there. Already two jump balls in this game.
Yeah, early in the possession, Lady Tigers were looking to get a mismatch inside with Mathurin, and end up going back to Jacobs inside.
Mathurin will pass it in. She gets it to Jacobs. Jacobs to pass out to Pippett. Pippett thinking about it, but she fakes it, and maybe a foul there. Baldwin will take it up, though. Baldwin looking to drive, but she gets it right out to Nielsen. And that is the Lady Tigers basketball. It'll be a turnover on Baldwin. Talia Jones taking it up the floor now. Talia Jones looking to score quick. Talia Jones for three, and it's good. What a good way to end the quarter for the Lady Tigers. Talia Jones with the buzzer beater three.
All right, that's the end of the first quarter, 11-7 Bixby. We'll take a short break and be back with more Lady Tiger basketball.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
And welcome back to another quarter of Lady Tigers basketball. And Talia Jones just hit the buzzer beater three to make it a 4-point game. And score is a 7-11.
They've had three threes on the Bixby has, and that's going to be probably a point of emphasis for Coach Coffee. I know that Madison Dildine was right behind the huddle listening to Coach Coffee as he was sharing some things with his team at the quarter. Madison, what's Coach Coffee focusing on right now?
wanting to Coach Coffey was really wanting to hold his team accountable in that huddle. He said, "We didn't play that great." Do you agree? He was really wanting them to focus on defense in this next quarter, guys.
Boxing out is another thing the Tigers have to focus on. And there goes Mays with the three. No good. Up with it was Mays. Mays gets the two there. Mathurin will take the ball up the floor. Baldwin guarding her. She gets the ball to Pippett. Pippett will get it to Jones. Jones up top. Jones looking to pass it back to Mathurin. And Mathurin, screen from Jacobs. Mathurin will just pull up for the midi. No good. And that'll be a rebound from Warnley. And Baldwin gets it right to Daniel, sorry. And Mathurin reflects the pass there, or deflects it. And what a cut from Nielsen there. And
yeah, looks like we're going to have a 30-second timeout. I know that Madison just talked about accountability and defense down there at the quarter, and we come out in this first minute, and I think Coach Coffey's not happy with the defense on this end of the court right now. So giving up an offensive rebound and a putback, that's just not finishing the possession, and then getting beat on the back door without help. We've got to do a better job defensively. We're fine, but we got to start executing defensively as well.
And immediately he called the timeout. He did not like what he saw. And you're coming right out. Grace Pippett will be inbounding the ball. Broken Arrow just looking for some offense here. Talia Jones will take the ball up the floor. She gets a screen from Jacobs. She uses it. Jacobs should have probably rolled Mathurin. The pass right to Jones, and she goes up with the floater, and it's no good. Warnley got the rebound there. Here comes Baldwin up the floor. She gets it right back to Warnley. And it looks like Daniel will come up top. Baldwin, pass to Warnley. Warnley up top, she will get it right inside. Baldwin will drive. Baldwin coming right back out. She gets it right to Nielsen. And there goes Daniel. And there goes, that was Warnley with the missed shot.
It's a great defensive possession for the Lady Tigers. You'll give up an 18-foot, 19-foot jump shot, and we'll take that all day long defensively.
Mathurin gets the screen from Pippett. She would drive with the left hand, and one. Mathurin. We'll have a chance to convert the and one at the free throw line. Tigers have been really aggressive with their drives so far. And just driving in and just doing all the dirty work.
Well, you know, big call for the Lady Tigers there because it's the second foul on Baldwin, on their point guard. Thomas has to make a decision whether to keep her in the game or is she going to try to get somebody else in. I guarantee you she told her she better not foul.
Baldwin will have it at top. Baldwin trying to cut. Nielsen the pass inside. And Daniel will shoot the three. No good. Rebound Nielsen, and she just goes right up with the reverse layup. Those offensive rebounds have been crucial so far.
We've got to keep her off the boards.
Hallie Kitchen has it. Up top to Pippett. Tanea Howard will drive. Tanea Howard almost loses it there, and she just throws it right to Daniel. That was Nielsen. Nielsen has it right there. The double team on Nielsen. And what a nice steal. Talia Jones up the floor. And she will finish right there.
Great finish by Talay, great pass by Mathurin. That's a way to get out and run and exit. We want to push tempo, make them, we'll take those shots.
The fast break and everything is everything to us. There goes Daniel up top. Baldwin popping out. Baldwin will pass it right into, and that was Nielsen with the fadeaway. Mathurin. Stopping Nielsen is a big time goal for us. There's Tanea Howard at the wing. Shoots it right to Mathurin. Talaya Jones has it. Talaya Jones sizing up. Talaya Jones maybe looking to take a step back three, but she says no. And she will anyways. No good.
Well, Mathurin was looking inside because she's got a size mismatch, and Baldwin's got two fouls, so that's where they're looking to get the ball inside. See if we can draw a third foul on her.
Getting her into foul trouble is crucial. Bixby will inbound. Baldwin, and what a steal. What an attempt from Mathurin there. And Nielsen will go up with the midi. And Nielsen can do all things with their game.
A little reverse pivot to create space and then an open look.
Mathurin, should we get the screen from Pippett? A double screen from Jacobs. She looks to pass it out to Hallie Kitchen. Hallie Kitchen will take it, no good. Jacobs trying to get the rebound, but Nielsen has it right there. Sorry, that was Mays. And Mays gets the rebound and goes up with it. And Mathurin will take the ball up the floor. Hallie Kitchen. And Mathurin looking around. Mathurin will drive. Mathurin will go up with it. No good, but she gets the rebound, but it is Bixby's ball. Knocked out of Mathurin's hands.
You know, offensively, we got to continue to be aggressive and see if we can draw fouls on Bixby. Get them in foul trouble. They've only, I mean, there hasn't been a lot of fouls called, but we got to continue to get good looks every possession. Elevator
and
screen.
There goes Mays. Or sorry, Warnley. Keep getting their numbers confused. Baldwin steals it right back. Baldwin looking. Got two bigs in the paint, and that is good for Mays. Mays with the little hook shot. Mathurin will take it up the floor. Mathurin sizing up. Mathurin, Baldwin all over her. Talaya Jones was cutting right out, but Grace Pippett with the corner three, no good. Here goes Baldwin. Baldwin to Daniel. Baldwin in the middle to Nichols. Sorry, Nielsen. No good on the three from Mays. And rebound from Mathurin. And almost a turnover there, but
it was a turnover on the outlet pass. Bixby's going to pull it out and get exactly the shot they want this last possession.
When they recovered, Baldwin sizing up on Mathurin. Baldwin with the crossover. Baldwin, a crafty little guard. They're looking to take the last shot.
Students trying to encourage Bixby to take a shot a little earlier.
And it works. Talaya Jones trying to look for part two. She will try to go up. What a three, one-handed, no good. Bixby 25, Broken Arrow 12.
We'll be back for more Lady Tiger basketball in just a few minutes.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
Your happy place is something special and different for everyone. You probably already know where to find yours, and TTCU Federal Credit Union can help you get there. Talk with our team. We'll give you the tools to build the financial future you want. So wherever your happy place finds you, TTCU will meet you there. TTCU Federal Credit Union. Life is better in balance.
Just a reminder, there will come a time when they can no longer share a bedroom. That's why we have a complete array of home loans so that dream of more space can come true. Right on time. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. The right balance.
Ladies.
coach, what's Bixby doing that you need to focus on in this second half?
The biggest thing that we got to focus on is locating their shooters and closing out with a purpose, and then rebounding the basketball. Those are the two biggest things we got to do right now to get ourselves back in the game.
Thanks, coach.
There, I mean, defensively, what he's talking about closing out and locating those shooters is that we got to get out there and get a hand in the face, and it's got to be very intentional. You know who your best three-point shooters are. You know if they want to drive or spot up, and so we've got to be more intentional. I think he used the word purposeful, having a purpose of getting out. And then, you know, defensively, we've done a good job sometimes on closing out contesting shots, but then we didn't block out afterwards, and we're giving up second shots. And when a team's got such a huge size advantage inside, giving them second shots and little chippies to put them back in, that just kills you defensively. You do a great job guarding them from 20 feet, and you give up a two-foot shot. And so we've got to finish those defensive possessions because we can't run until we get the ball. And that's, you know, as a coach, you got to think, I got to get the ball first, and then we can get out and run. So we've got some things that we can get back into it. Miles, we were down 19 last time we played him. So this lead is not too big, but we got to start chipping away and do it with great effort and being intentional in what we do.
Chipping away slowly at their lead, just, you know, taking smart shots, making sure we're not turning over the ball, and just moving everywhere. I mean, we have to stop Nielsen on the rebounds for sure, because
Nielsen's really hurt us. She's hurt us on the boards, and we've had some turnovers that were just kind of unforced turnovers, maybe some frustration turnovers, and so we've got to do a better job taking care of the basketball. When we get a stop, we don't want to turn the ball over. I think we've had two turnovers on outlet passes, and that's, I'm sure Coach Coffey's not real happy. You don't ever want turnovers, but on an outlet pass when you've got possession to give that ball right back to him and not get something out of it just kind of hurts. So this will be an opportunity. Coach Galden, Lexus, getting in there, giving a little bit of wisdom to the players as they're getting ready to start back out. I know she's got a lot of knowledge in basketball, and so, hey, we're going to keep after it. There is no quit in this team. They're going to fight, and they're going to compete, and we're going to start. There is no 13-point shot. It's just one possession at a time, so you got to win the possession, and that's how you got to break it down.
And once again, in the last meeting with the Bixby Spartans, we were down 19, and we came back. So let's see what they have for us this half. Tigers moving it around the perimeter. Mathurin will take it in. Mathurin with the spin move, and immediately she gets it to go. Great sign for the Tigers. Baldwin will take it up the floor.
And that's what, you know, that's a good mismatch for us. Mathurin, Baldwin trying to guard her. She can't stop her inside at the post. Got a big size advantage, and plus Baldwin's also got two fouls.
And Bixby just moving it around the perimeter. Talia Jones with her defense, Mathurin with her defense, and Grace Pippett comes up with the steal. And she will take the easy two, and it is a single-digit game. Mathurin guarding Baldwin. Bixby moving it. There goes Daniel. And she gets it right back out. No good. Three-pointer from her. Baldwin with the rebound on it. Baldwin showing how crafty she is. Baldwin. Baldwin, the pass to in the corner. She gets it right back to the corner. Daniel has it up top, and another bad pass for Bixby. And they're looking to go inside in the back door from Daniel, and she misses the easy layup. Grace Pippett comes up with the rebound.
Bixby showed a lot of patience offensively, and man, we'll take that. We give up a layup. They missed the layup, and now we've got a chance to cut into the lead a little bit more.
Thurin gets the screen from Howard. She will go in once again, barely off the marker. Daniel comes up with the rebound. Looking to drive. Bixby drives, and looks like they're going to call a shooting foul there. And that is Warnley, who will go to the line and shoot two.
I got out in transition and got back, and she initiated the contact, got in there, and
Broken Arrow starting off with the first 4 points of the half. This already seems like a different ball team coming in.
Yeah, well, I mean, we get a couple stop shot off the bat and picked up the intensity defensively, and that's going to be the key to the game is we've got to pick up the defensive intensity and get some stops.
Warnley splits the pair there. Thurn will take the ball up the floor. Jones looking. Screen Howard. Jones getting double-teamed. And no backcourt violation, but there will be a reaching foul, possibly.
Kind of a later call by the official there. He will take it. I'm sure Talia was ready for that. It wasn't late for her. She was ready for them to call blow the whistle there.
Allie Kitchen will inbound. Mathurin. Broken Arrow just chipping at that lead. Allie Kitchen has it up top. Howard. Looks like they're looking to get a two here. Herrera drives in. And Herrera right from the outside. No good. And a rebound from Mays. Bixby has it. Bixby, the pass in the corner. The midi air ball there. And Talia Jones has it.
One of the toughest shots in the game is on the baseline. And we will take that stop defensively.
Another defensive stop for the Tigers. Mathurin driving in, and she gets it to go and one for the Tigers. Mathurin will try to convert the end one at the line. And an 8-point lead. Thurin looking to make it a 7-point lead.
Once again, taking advantage of one of our mismatches inside. Mackenzie Mathurin has the size over. She can just go over and shoot over the defender.
Misses a free throw there, but it's okay. And timeout.
We've got a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout. Coach Thomas is not happy with what she's seen down there, so I'm sure Madison will be I don't know if she can listen into what Coach Coffey's talking about or not, but, you know, Bixby offensively, they've been patient on a couple possessions and got good looks. The shots didn't fall. Our offense right now is really feeding off of our defense, so we've got to get that stop and get out and run, but we can't give up second shots. And I guarantee you Coach Coffey's talking about don't give up second shots. Keep them to one shot, contest. We'll get the ball and come back down. We've got a great mismatch size-wise, and Mathurin's got to take advantage of that.
And the Lady Tigers down 8 now. They trailed by 13 at the half. And just keep chipping at that lead. One at a time. And Daniel will pass the ball in. Baldwin, the playmaker. We'll get double-teamed, and Herrera pokes it loose, but it looks to be a jump ball. And that will be Bixby's ball.
You know, that counts, yes, a jump ball, and they got the ball back, but that is such a momentum play for Herrera to cause. Just defensively, when that ball screen came, she double-teamed. They get the ball back, but we're going to get the next possession of the jump ball. So great effort play defensively for her.
Herrera with the great effort. Bixby moving around, and she drives, and it is a shooting foul. And Warnley will go to the line.
It's going to be on tonight, Howard.
Already, I believe, 2 fouls to start the half.
Yeah, that's her third foul, but yes, two team fouls are off the bat. So, you know, Tanae does a really good job inside for us athletically and defensively getting rebounds and everything, and so that's someone with a lot of experience. And it's going to be a quick substitution coming in.
Warnley will spit the pair there. Broken Arrow. Try to score one more.
I say defensively that
he gets her with the
Coach
walk
Thomas
there.
Made a switch defensively on matchups there. They took Baldwin off of Mathera and put someone with a little more size on her. So she goes inside. I think Mays picked her up that time when she went inside. Little chess match going.
And Baldwin has it once again. Looked like Daniel was cutting there. Almost tries to get the pick and roll, but Mathurin knocks it out. Will be Bixby's ball. And the Jungle Squad is over there pestering Bixby's team. Warnley, the pass inside. And the steal looked like from Pippett. Talia Jones has it. Mathurin looking to find a shot here. Hallie Kitchen has it in the corner. Talia Jones will pop out. Talia Jones looking to drive, and what a drive from Talia Jones. Broken Arrow working their way up with twos.
It's a good read defensively. They backed off, a little stutter step, change of pace. Got the defense out of position, and Talia finishes.
Beautiful move baseline from Talia Jones. Daniel will drive. And believe it was on the floor. So Bixby will have it once again. Bixby. Three around the perimeter. Baldwin has it. Nielsen is in the paint. Or I'm sorry, that is Mays, and she misses there.
Great help defense by Hallie Kitchen down there to clog up the first time to contest the shot, and then Herrera did a good job playing physical inside.
And there goes Herrera for three, air ball, but Talia Jones tries to rebound it there, but it looked like Warnley knocked it out there, so Broken Arrow will still have the ball. Mathurin passing in. Talia Jones cutting to the corner. Oh, and just a miscommunication between Mathurin and Talia Jones there. Baldwin will take it up the floor. Baldwin, the crossover, Mathurin all over her. And Mathurin all over here, and the Jungle Squad loves what they see.
Great defensive effort by McKenzie right there.
Right back out to Baldwin. Baldwin will shoot the three. No good. Rebound Pippett. And another stop for the Broken Arrow Tigers. We have numbers. The pass to Hallie Kitchen. And maybe a foul there.
The Tigers still have the ball. Great job in transition, and we got a good look. They block it, but we still got the ball. See how we execute our out-of-bounds play here.
And another stop for the Lady Tigers. Mathurin up top. Mathurin will get blocked. Mays with the block, and up there, no good, but Nielsen just missed it, and another stop for the Tigers.
And that is why you always follow the shooter. Even on breakaway layups, people can miss them. So we get the ball back, another possession.
Talia Jones gets a screen from Pippett there, and she will shoot the ball. No good air ball, but Jacobs with the save, and it is out. What an effort from Jacobs, though.
Yep, good effort. We got to keep fighting. We've got 60, just under 60 seconds left in this quarter. We've made a dent in it. It's time to, once again, just win the possession.
It is a 7-point lead with 45 seconds to go in the third quarter. Hallie Kitchen with the defense. There goes Baldwin. Baldwin driving in. Baldwin will pass it in the corner. Looks like no good. And Warnley has it. Shot from Mays was no good. Baldwin, the pass right out. She decides not to shoot it. Jungle squad pestering them. Talia Jones. Talia Jones all over Warnley there. She decides not to shoot the open three there. She will drive, no good. Daniel up with it, no good. And the rebound from Mathurin. And definitely a great ending to the third quarter there. Broken Arrow Tigers have been getting stops.
Yeah, absolutely. So we'll end of the third quarter, 27-20. We're trailing, but we'll be right back after this short message.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
Welcome back to the fourth quarter of Broken Arrow Lady Tigers versus the Bixby Spartan. And we made a 13-point lead into a 7-point lead coming into this quarter. And it started with the defensive end.
Absolutely. And we're going to jump down there to Madison's been right behind the Lady Tiger bench. Madison, what's Coach Coffey talking about right now?
Yeah, guys, he was expressing to his team that he knows that they have been fighting hard and they were limiting shots. He said he wants them to slow down and just execute and play ball, guys.
Yeah, that's great. You know, execution, because we did a you know, great job defensively. The intensity, the purposefulness was greater in the third quarter. I mean, obviously we just held a really good team to 2 points in the quarter, and as a coach, you'll take that all day long. That's great defensive pressure from us.
And Mathurin will drive, and with the left hand there, and another two for the Tigers. Talia Jones, who hasn't got it going tonight, we'd love to get her going. And Bixby has it. Baldwin. And in the paint is Nielsen. Nielsen constantly in the paint, looking to score an easy bucket. Baldwin in the corner.
Bixby showing great, you know, patience offensively.
A low-scoring game here tonight, 22-27, compared to last game, which was 61-56. So definitely a defensive matchup, and that looked to be Warnley up with it, and it is no good. Tigers looking to make it a
5 point right now. You know, Mays made a great move to the basket, but we did a good job getting the rebound, and now we're gonna come back down and just a two possession game right now.
Mathurin, Pippet has it up top. Howard. Howard will drive, and another drive for Broken Arrow. 3 point game. Bixby looking to cut the momentum of these Broken Arrow Lady Tigers. Warnley up with it, and it is good. Warnley with the three. What an answer.
Yeah, it's been we've held them off the three-point line and haven't given up open looks in a long time, and so that was a big answer from Bixby. But once again, just a two-possession game.
Broken Arrow, another team held off the three-point line, and it looks to be a illegal screen.
Yeah. Called a foul on Pippet. Looks like we're going to have a 30-second timeout. So we will we'll stay here for the 30-second timeout. You know, sometimes offensively that team that slows it down is very purposeful. Sometimes it just changes. It's hard to get that that tempo that we want to play, sometimes they can lull you to sleep a little bit defensively. And so I know Coach Coffey is, once again, we're having to get stops on the defensive end and then come down and capitalize, but we can't become impatient ourselves and take bad shots. So you know, this is we're right in the middle of this game. It is a low-scoring game, yes, like you said, not like the last time they played, but we're right in the middle of this.
Yes, more of a defensive battle here tonight, and just the comeback from the Lady Tigers once again. You know, just being, you know, tonight, if they are able to execute it, that will be something they are trying to do here. Coach Coffey giving Hallie Kitchen the pat on the back there.
Yeah, a lot of times she's a player that makes a difference in a lot of ways that don't show up on the stat sheet. So that's a key player. It's going to be important for our success going into late February and March.
And the Tigers are pressing. Mathurin, Baldwin looking to drive, and the block from Mathurin. Bixby will have it. Mathurin all over Baldwin. Baldwin looking to pass in. She passes it to the cutting Warnley, and they get it right back out. Good effort. Bixby moving it around. Constantly cutting to the basket. And Nielsen almost loses it there, but a rebound from Baldwin. And an air ball by Bixby there. Hallie Kitchen will take it up the floor, and the running Talia Jones with the left hand.
Great pass. Way to run the floor, Talia, but man, unselfish play for the Lady Tigers.
Just being able to convert on transition offense is beautiful. Bixby
taking advantage of our athleticism.
And the cutting Baldwin, and that'll be an and one. What a shot from Baldwin there. She will take one. She will make it there.
Got beat on a backdoor cut, and just help defense was just a step late, and to give up a three-point play.
A seven-point lead for Bixby now. And Grace Pippett will shoot the three, and it's good. Grace Pippett with the three makes it a four-point lead.
All right, Coach Coffey's called a full timeout, so we'll take a short break, and we'll wait for Madison to let us know about the timeout. Here we go. Good job, Lady Tigers, 33-29.
Finding your happy place is something special and different for everyone. You probably already know where to find yours, and TTCU Federal Credit Union can help you get there. Talk with our team. We'll give you the tools to build the financial future you want. So wherever your happy place finds you, TTCU will meet you there. TTCU Federal Credit Union. Life is better in balance.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and we have a tight one here once again, 33-29. Broken Arrow Lady Tigers have stormed all the way back from 13 at the half. And what have they done that's been so impressive in the second half?
You know, defensively, our intensity's picked up, which I know is a point of emphasis for Coach Coffey, but we're getting stops, but we're coming down and we're finishing shots inside. And so that don't quit attitude, man, it's showing up tonight. And so we're giving Bixby all they can handle. I know that Madison just left the huddle and listened to Coach Coffey as he was sharing. Madison, what was Coach Coffey sharing?
He says, you've got to want this more than anyone right now. We've got to get aggressive and finish this ball game, guys.
There we go. We're 4 minutes away, and it's a four-point game. So Coach Coffey's imploring them, encouraging them. They want to win. They've just got to execute on the court. We're going to pick up full court right here. Once again, this is going to control tempo and take them out of that half-court set, make them play faster, which is to our advantage.
And the Lady Tigers are pressing here. Mathurin. The Tigers are looking to get revenge from their last meeting. Bixby moving the ball around. Talia Jones almost gets a deflect there. And the pass to the wing, and Warnley will miss it. No good. Rebound, Mathurin. The Tigers with another stop on defense. Talia Jones cutting to the three. And Pippett will try to make it two in a row there. No good, but Talia Jones with the effort. Talia Jones, and she is blocked there. Look to be Nielsen with the block. Or sorry, that was Mays with the block. And another timeout for Broken Arrow.
I think Bixby's called a full timeout, so we will take a quick break and be right back.
Just a reminder, there will come a time when they can no longer share a bedroom. That's why we have a complete array of home loans so that dream of more space can come true. Right on time. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. The right balance.
And welcome back to more Lady Tigers action, and Broken Arrow just took another time out. And
yeah, so Coach Thomas called a timeout that time for Bixby because she didn't have her ball handler handling the ball in the backcourt, was in a bad situation. Looking back, you want to call something before you turn it over, and she looked up, and by the time she called it, she realized they had somebody wide open down there. But she wanted her ball handlers having the ball, not maybe the one that was bringing the ball to court. So.
And Daniel will pass it in. Baldwin is shown to be a crafty playmaker here tonight. And Mays will have it right back to Baldwin. Bixby moving the ball around. Howard trying to get the steal there, and she just goes right up with it. A good shot from Mays there. Mathurin. Broken Arrow will move the ball around. Waves off the Howard screen. And a little backdoor cut from Kitchen. Doesn't get it.
Mathurin's trying to get inside.
And Mathurin. She will go up with it, and she will go to the line for two.
Called it on the floor. Yeah, the foul was on the floor. Called the foul on the floor.
Originally, I think the ref signaled too. Grace Pippett has it up top. Jones will have it. Screen Howard. Howard cuts. Jones, who hasn't been able to get it going tonight. And Mathurin will cut, but she will decide to go up with it, and Mays just takes it right from her hand. Baldwin will pass it up. Bixby Spartans probably looking to drain a little clock here. Passing the ball around here. Broken Arrow has the chip at the ball. Bixby still draining clock.
This will be the sixth team foul on Lay Tigers, so not in the 1-1 yet. You know, we really, Bixby ran a lot of time off the clock. They had 5-on-4 down there as Mathurin was getting her shoe back on this end, and they just kept passing the ball around.
Broken Arrow desperate of a stop here. Bixby just wasting the clock. Jones has it. Spin move from Warnley. Warnley goes up with it, and no good. Once again, another offensive rebound for Bixby. And Mays will go to the line and shoot two. As Bixby has entered the penalty.
So the fifth team foul, Tanae Howard fouls out. He gave up another offensive rebound, and they're going to go to the line and have a chance to score with the clock stopped.
And I'm hoping Mays misses one here. She hits the first one. And timeout from Coach Coffey.
All right, we'll take a quick break. We've got a minute 24 left in action. Lady Tigers trail 29-36.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
We are back with 1 minute remaining in the fourth quarter. And we have, I believe, Mays at the free throw line right now. And the Tigers just looking to score quick so they could keep chipping at this lead.
Yeah, so minute 24 is a lot of time, okay, in a game like this. But we've got to get out and come down and score quickly. We can't give up any second shots, especially on a free throw when you've got numbers. Don't give up a missed free throw.
Offensive rebound was crucial, and Mays will hit the second one. Now an eight-point game. Tigers moving quick. Kitchen has it. She gets it right into Mathurin. Mathurin, and she will get it deflected by Mays.
Once again, we're trying to take advantage of a mismatch inside, going with Mathurin.
Talia Jones popping out. Talia Jones.
Trying to get something going to the basket right here.
She would get the screen from Jacobs. Warnley all over her. Pass in once again to Mathurin, and looks to be a...
Going to be reach in on... Well, I thought they were going to call it on Mays, but well, okay. A foul nonetheless. Stops the clock.
Mathurin holding her elbow there. Kitchen.
Called that one on Baldwin. Once again, quick foul on them.
Baldwin in foul trouble.
It's her fourth foul. She was trying to deny the cut, but hanging on a little too much.
Mathurin will pass the ball in. Hallie Kitchen has it in the corner. Mathurin has it up top. Mathurin Jacobs will pop out. Or sorry, that was Talia Jones. And Daniel. She's looking to finish it there. And it is good. Bixby now leads by 10. Tigers looking to score quick. They're looking to get a three-pointer here. Talia Jones will just shoot it. No good for her tonight. And that is a rebound from Mays. And Bixby will take it up the floor. And Bixby will win the game. What a great game from these two teams tonight.
Yeah, Lady Tigers fall 39-29. A very different game than what we had when they played in the end of 2021. This is going to be another opportunity to be able to learn. And great effort. They fought all the way to the very end. And so great job by the Lady Tigers. I'm going to continue to learn. And the goal is that you get better every day because we're getting ready for February and March. And so we appreciate everybody joining us for Lady Tiger basketball. And we will... I think take a break and get ready for some action between the Bixby Spartans and the Tigers. Thanks for joining us.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to a huge Aerovision broadcast. Here tonight, we have your Broken Arrow Tigers taking on the Bixby Spartans. I'm Ethan Scott, joined along Greg Spencer. Greg, new year, new goals, new court. How are we feeling about this game tonight?
Yeah, I know. It feels like a lot has changed since we were last here. It's been about 2 or 3 weeks. The Tigers have actually played 4 games since we were last doing a game on Aerovision in that close one-point loss against Bartlesville. Tigers now 5-2 on the season. When we last broadcasted, they were ranked number 2 in the state. They've now dropped to 5. Didn't really get any credit back up the polls by the voters this week in the OK rankings. But I know Coach Wallace's team definitely made an impression in Arizona. Played 4 games there, went 3-1, made it to the finals of a pretty good tournament, and then played a nationally known ranked team from Perry High School in Arizona, kind of in the Scottsdale area. They faced one of the best seniors in the nation, a 7-footer that signed with Arizona, as well as 2 kids that are going to play high major college ball, a freshman and a sophomore, and ended up going into the finals in that championship and losing by 1 in overtime. Coach Wallace actually said that he felt like they probably would have won in regulation if there had been if there had not been a shot clock in that tournament, which there was, which we're not used to playing. He said that he felt like there were a few possessions late in the game that they probably shot a little bit too quick. It might have cost them, ended up losing. Perry got the ball with about 8 seconds left, ran a play for one of their better players, and got a bucket right around the buzzer. So impressive tournament for the Tigers. One of the things, though, that he was most proud of was really kind of the response that he got from people, coaches, different people that saw Broken Arrow that weren't necessarily familiar with them at the tournament. And a funny story he told me today when we were talking, he said, shortly after they lost the game against Perry, kind of a short, heavy-set man came up to him and started complimenting him on how well their team played. And he said, at the back of my mind, I kind of recognized the guy, but had no idea who he was, just because, you know, I was worried about the loss and the one-point loss. And he finishes the conversation with a guy, you know, just talking about how well-coached they were and how hard they played. He goes back and talks with Coach King, and Coach King and him confirmed that it was Frank Caliendo, the comedian that you may know from Fox broadcast, famous for a lot of imitations. So then they go back to the hotel after the game or the restaurant, and they're chatting, thinking it's kind of funny that Frank Caliendo came up to him. So they go on Twitter just to confirm that that was definitely him. They both follow him on Twitter, and within 30 minutes, Frank Caliendo followed both Coach King and Coach Wallace back.
That's hilarious.
And sent him another nice message on Twitter talking about how he appreciated him. So funny story there from Coach Wallace talking about that tournament. You always love to go make an impression whenever you're representing BA going to an out-of-state tournament.
Well, speaking of Coach Wallace and Coach King, you told me earlier that you have been talking to them lately leading up to this game. What have they told you?
Well, kind of finishing up some things about their Arizona tournament. One more note about Perry. Perry actually played Sierra Canyon, which a lot of people know because of Bronny James and some other nationally known guys. Lost to him, I believe he said, by 12 in a tournament in Phoenix. So that kind of gives you an indication the type of teams across the nation that this BA team can play with. Like I said, a shot clock tournament. One of the things that Coach Wallace was most impressed with in the Perry tournament was the way that Ethan shot in those last 2 games. He hit 13 threes. So if you look at Ethan's stats on the season, I believe I looked this up earlier, and Ethan is shooting about 57% from three-point range on the season. 51%. He's 19 of 37 on the season, coming off back-to-back games with 13 threes. So they're going to need to carry that over going against a kid like Parker Fredrickson that can shoot the three himself. What do you know about Parker?
Well, Parker is definitely a star player for this team. You know, he's been definitely the shining light for Bixby so far on the season. I was also talking to Coach Wallace a little bit earlier. You know, you got to know where he is at all times. That's what Coach Wallace was telling me. He's a very, very strong shooter for sure. His three-point game is really good. You want to minimize space with him. And you want to provide charge opportunities as well because he loves to penetrate the basket. We'll be right back with the national anthem. We are back from the national anthem. Spencer, would you like to go over the Bixby starters here for tonight?
Sure, why not? Starting, we actually have a different starter than I expected, but it looks like number zero, Cam McCrary, 6'2 senior, is starting tonight, along with number one, Tristan Driver. And, of course, we've got number five, the 6'3 junior Parker Fredrickson. And number 11, Spencer Holly starting. So a couple surprise starters tonight. And then finally, number 22, Connor Shifley.
For Broken Arrow tonight, talked to coach before the game. Did say it'd be the same starters, but, I mean, if they're surprise starters for Bixby, could also be surprise starters here for Broken Arrow.
Having some light issues.
Lights, yeah. So we have Braden Johnson starting at point guard. We're going to have Connor Dow at shooting guard. At small forward, we're going to have Anthony Allen. And power forward, it's going to be Ethan Ellison. And also running a guard spot will be Aaron Johnson. Tigers liking to run a two forward, three guard type of lineup. And those are your starters here tonight for the Broken Arrow Tigers. So, speaking of Parker Fredrickson, Spencer, who is a player that we definitely want to put on him to stop him from going on a scoring rampage like he usually does?
Well, as always, you're going to typically start your game with Aaron Johnson having the toughest defensive assignment. But, this is similar, even though they're different players, comparing him to David Castillo, but similar assignments whenever you have a team that has one guy that scores a lot of points. You're always going to try and throw a little bit different stuff at him here and there. One thing different about Bixby, not to say that they don't have other guys that can contribute. In fact, Coach Wallace told me that they all have the green light pretty much at all times. But there's not – some of those secondary pieces aren't guys that you worried about as much compared to the last game against Bartlesville.
And Anthony Allen's going to win the tip and start us off here tonight. Aaron Johnson dribbling it up here for the Tigers. Passes it to Ethan Ellison, who gets it inside to Allen. Allen goes up. He's automatically going to be fouled, it looks like.
Ethan, you always like when the Tigers make a concentrated effort to get Anthony an early touch, and he's going to make him pay going to the line where he's actually shooting a very impressive – I highlighted this, 85% on the season. Always like a big man that can shoot that well from the free throw line.
For sure. As he hits both of his free throws here. Start the Tigers off. With it is going to be Spencer Holly. Holly will find Driver. Shot is no good there for Connor Shifley. And Connor Dow will carry it up. finds Johnson, who gets into Allen, who goes up with a nice little fundamental-type layup there.
Yeah, and just another example, Aaron Johnson, always unselfish, looking for his teammates. He's really one of those guys that you probably like to see score, or at least try to score a little bit more sometimes, but you always love him doing the dirty work.
Fredrickson goes in. It's going to be tipped there by Downs. It's going to be taken right away by Anthony Allen. With it's Ethan Ellison. Ellison goes right, goes up, and it's in. Nice little early 6-0 run here for the Tigers.
Tigers off to a hot start, getting their big guys finishing in the paint. Got to love the easy looks that they've got so far.
Fredrickson finds Driver. Driver's going to be fouled there by Braden Johnson.
Yeah, and talking with Coach Wallace before the game, those are the kind of fouls that he wants them to stay away from. If you recall in the Bartlesville game, a lot of hand-checking fouls were called against them that weren't in scoring areas, and that's a perfect example right there of a bad situation. Nobody's about to do anything to you. Get your hands off and defend.
It is going to be an and one there for Cam McCrary.
Yeah, bad trip down the floor for the Tigers. They pick up two fouls and possibly give up 3 points if he can knock that down.
But he will not be able to convert there. Now with his Aaron Johnson taking it up slowly. Guarding him will be Fredrickson. Aaron Johnson setting up the play here. A double screen by Ellison and Allen. Finds Ellison at the top of the key, gets it inside to Allen.
You see the amount of attention that Anthony is drawing there. Three guys collapse on him. He's got to keep that ball high.
It was definitely great defense there by Fredrickson to knock it loose. So he goes left, passes out to McCrary. McCrary for three. It's good. And that'll make it 6-5 here. And now with it is Aaron Johnson. Inside to Allen, who finds Dow. Dow makes his defender jump, goes up for the mid-range shot, and it's blocked by McCrary. But McCrary loses it right away out of bounds. We'll go back to the Broken Arrow Tigers.
So McCrary, a guy that we didn't even expect to start, coming off the, you know, coming into the starting lineup tonight.
Causing trouble.
Yeah, all over the place so far.
Connor Dowd inbounded here. Finds Aaron Johnson. Gets it back to Dow here. Finds Ellison, but then passes to Aaron Johnson. Back to Connor Dowd at the corner for three. It's no good off the front of the rim. Rebound by Fredrickson.
Bixby did a nice job getting out there and contesting Connor's look. Looked like he was going to have a better look at first.
Holly goes up. No foul called as his hands are straight up, but it's going to be picked up there by Driver. It's going to be taken.
Oh, my. That was not a good call. We'll just leave it at that.
Not too sure what the what even happened. I didn't even see anything.
She said he got him on the wrist, but that 99% of the people in this building just said that was all ball. Coach Wallace having a word.
Passing it in is Holly. Holly gets it to Shifley. Shifley back to Holly. Holly goes up. Good contest there by Anthony Allen to make the not make the shot. Ethan Ellison with it. Goes up. Nice little finger roll type shot there. He'll put the Tigers up 8-5. Now that's Parker Fredrickson.
Ethan using his offhand there with the right-hand layup, which as a lefty, not always the easiest thing to do there, but he finished.
Holly with the mid-range shot. Too easy there for him. Gets it to Aaron Johnson. Johnson to Ellison. Back to Johnson. Johnson just takes it all by himself, and he's going to be fouled there. That'll send him to the line for two.
Fans watching the game that may have joined us a little bit late might notice this broadcast looks drastically different to them at home as the Tigers over Christmas break got a brand new court. Talked to Coach Wallace about it, and he said that they really like it. Both him and Coach Coffey had a lot of input along with Steve Dunn, the athletic director. So it definitely has a not only a different look in person, but a different look on the broadcast as well.
It's a very nice-looking court.
A little reminiscent of the Brooklyn Nets court,
sure,
but with a little
sure.
more – at least we got some gold color in it. So the red out there really pops right now, though.
Fredrickson with it. Being guarded by Aaron Johnson. He goes left. Goes up. Blocked by Allen, but it's picked up right away by Fredrickson, who gets it out to McCrary. Now with it is Holly. Holly loses it. He's able to pick it back up. She shoots a top of the key three. It's off the front of the rim, no good, and they're just going to let that one go out of bounds. It'll be Broken Arrow ball. Good defense there by the Tigers.
Example of the fact that, Bixby has a lot of guys with the green light right there. That wasn't really necessarily a great shot. Just kind of picked up the loose ball and let it fly.
Aaron Johnson goes in, just takes the mid-range shot, and it's good.
I think Aaron's going to have an opportunity to have a big night tonight. You know, Fredrickson's a guy that's guarding him right now. He's going to want to stay out of foul trouble as he's their main offensive guy. So I would expect Anthony to have a chance to step up.
Gets it to Holly. Holly shoots the mid-range back. No good. It's going to be rebounded there by Nick Fredrickson. Goes up, blocked by Al. Oh, it's a foul.
I said Anthony. I meant Braden. Sorry about that.
Student section not happy about that call. It's going to be two free throws here for Nick Fredrickson. His first free throw is good. He's able to make both there. The sub will go in for Driver. It's going to be number three, Luke Fredrickson. Three Fredricksons on this Bixby lineup. That'll be fun.
That is not a note that I had before the game. We'll just call them by their first names.
Carrying it up the floor is Aaron Johnson. Gets it to Braden Johnson. Top of the key is Aaron Johnson. Goes in. He's going to be fouled there. That'll send him to the line for two. Johnson's going to miss the first free throw there. He has an opportunity to put the Tigers up four here. It's a little over 3 minutes and 30 seconds of the first quarter. Parker Fredrickson with it. Now with it is Holly. Holly back to Parker Fredrickson. Fredrickson goes up. No good. It's going to be a fight for the ball there between Connor Dow and Sean Page. And it's going to be Bixby ball.
Now, similar to the Bartlesville game, Tigers doing a good job early on the key guy, just like they did with Castillo, as Parker only has zero at the moment. Yep, good call.
And it's a travel right away. That'll be broken arrow ball. Turnovers could possibly be a problem here for the Bixby Spartans tonight. Guarding Johnson is Parker Fredrickson. They get inside to Allen. Allen goes up. He's no good. Now with it is Parker Fredrickson. Braden Johnson guarding. Finds Holly. Connor Dow guarding Holly. Holly goes left. Gets it to Parker Fredrickson. Fredrickson finds it to Page. Page for three. It's good for Sean Page. And that cuts the lead down to one for the Broken Arrow Tigers.
Well, Coach Wallace talked about everybody needs to get out and contest, guys. You got to know that every single guy that they put out there will shoot it and can shoot it. And that's what we're seeing right now is Bixby's secondary guys are keeping them in this game and now giving them the lead.
That's a good layup there for Nick Fredrickson. It's going to be a timeout from Coach Wallace. Broken Arrow need to definitely stop the transition here so far and the three-point shot. Everybody has a green light, as you were saying, Spencer. Spencer, what can they do to improve that?
Well, it's about defending. You know, we got off to a hot start, 6-0, and now you've seen a little bit of a letdown. Usually probably a pretty good timeout here by Coach Wallace. I want to mention that tonight we have Madison Dildine with us here tonight. You may know Madison from the football games this year. She worked the sidelines, and we've got her with us here tonight. Madison, how are you doing tonight? Well, we did have her. We will hope to go to her if she hears us later. Probably before halftime, but we'll try to get with her sometime before then.
Broken Arrow going out here with a newer look. Jason Cook and David Howell will go in for Ethan Ellison and Braden Johnson. Aaron Johnson has it. Finds David Howe. David Howe's just completely fouled there.
I think we have Madison now. Let's go ahead and go down to her. She was in the huddle during the timeout. Madison, how are you doing tonight?
I'm good. Thanks, guys. Coach Wallace was really, really, really expressing to his team that you've got to keep attacking. He said you win the game in the paint. Be aggressive, guys.
All right. Thanks, Madison.
Now with it is Aaron Johnson. Guarding him is Parker Fredrickson. He finds David Howe. Howe to Allen. Back out to Howe. Howe for three. It's no good, but it's going to be rebounded by Johnson, who gets it back to Anthony Allen. Great rebound there by Aaron Johnson. So athletic. Anthony Allen to Howe. Another three for David Howe. That one's also no good. It's going to be rebounded by Sean Page. Page to Holly. Back to Page. Parker Fredrickson with it now. Takes a heat check type three. It's not going to be good. Good defense from Aaron Johnson, but it's rebounded by McCrary. Out to this Page. Finds Holly. A good pass there from Page. It's no good there from Holly. And now with it is David Howe. Finds Connor Dow here on the break. And he loses it there. A turnover there from Connor Dow. And now with it is Fredrickson. Fredrickson goes up. And it's going to be a blocking foul called there on Aaron Johnson.
Well, good effort there by Aaron. He had the right idea, but he really was not quite in place. That's one of those risky situations when you get to the block that you're not always going to get that charge call. But on the offensive end right now, the Tigers just looking a little sluggish. A couple good looks by Howell for three, but that's been kind of one of the problems for the Tigers on the season so far is really outside of Braden and Connor, they're not getting a lot of other people hitting three-pointers. We talked earlier about Connor being 19 to 37 on the season, over 50%. Well, Braden Johnson is even better than that in less attempts at 9 of 17. So they got to get more looks from the guys that are knocking them down, and they need the guys that aren't knocking them down to start knocking them down.
Speaking of Connor Dow, Justice Sutton will go in for him. Aaron Johnson finds Sutton in the corner. Sutton passes inside there to Aaron Johnson. Johnson goes up. No good. It's going to be rebounded there by Parker Fredrickson, who finds Holly. Holly gets it to Nick Fredrickson. And he's just going to turn it over right away there to Aaron Johnson. Aaron Johnson into Anthony Allen. And it's a good little layup there for Anthony Allen as he puts the Tigers up two.
Tigers got to find a way to keep getting Anthony touches. They got to let, you know, they made a concentrated effort there at the beginning stages of the first quarter, but that was the first shot he's taken in a while.
Page with a heat check three. It's no good. They're just going to let that one go out of bounds, and it'll be Broken Arrow Tiger basketball. Going in for Bixby.
It's tough to keep up with it. I believe they played about 10 guys already in the first quarter. Here comes another one, number 12. We've seen, or he was actually supposed to start, and I don't think he did.
Number 12 being
Sam McCormick.
Sam McCormick, yep.
So they have played 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That was right, 10 guys.
McCormick is in for Bixby, as well as Driver. And also number 15, Jonah Sermon.
I'm not sure I've ever seen a coach play 10 guys in a first quarter of a tie game.
Well, it's working for him so far here on the defensive end, especially with it is McCrary. Finds McCormick, who finds Parker Fredrickson. He goes right, steps back, makes Howell jump. That's no good. Rebound, Justice Sutton. And that right there will end the first quarter here. A very close matchup. Obviously, it's tied here 15-15. And we will be right back after a couple of our messages from our sponsors.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
And we are back here for the start of the second quarter. 15-15 is your score between your Broken Arrow Tigers and the Bixby Spartans. Greg, you talked about how the offense for the Tigers is looking a bit sluggish here tonight. What can they do to improve that?
Well, they're just a little out of control right now. You know, Bixby's throwing some junk defenses out at them, giving them some different looks. Really a lot of effort. I mean, Bixby's playing hard. Like we said, they played 10 guys already. So it looks like they're trying to stay fresh and throw a lot of different guys at it. And really everything Coach Wallace told us before the game about Bixby having a lot of effort guys off the bench. We've seen interchangeable parts and nobody really afraid to shoot. And, you know, just like the last game that we did here on AeroVision with the Tigers shutting down David Castillo for pretty much the whole half, they just held Parker Fredrickson scoreless for a quarter, yet come away tied.
With it is Dow. He finds Braden Johnson. Gets it back to Connor Dow. Dow back to Braden Johnson. Johnson goes in. He's going to lose the ball there, but looks like it's going to be a charge by Cam McCrary.
Yeah, just again kind of going back to being a little bit out of control. You got to penetrate those gaps and attack that zone, which he tried to do, but you got to come to a better, you know, triple threat jump stop and then find a guy, and that's not what happened.
After that personal foul there by Braden Johnson, he's immediately subbed out after being subbed in for only about 30 seconds for Ethan Ellison.
Well, that tells you that Coach Wallace probably talked to him about something and then it did not translate to the court, so he's going to have another moment to think about it.
Parker Fredrickson fades away there. Nice little shot there from Parker Fredrickson. So he'll put the Bixby Spartans up 17-15. With it, Sutton. Sutton loses it there, but it's picked up by Ellison and he's going to be fouled there by Jonas Sermon. Fredrickson a little slow to get up, but just gets help from his teammates.
Yeah, first points of the night for Parker Fredrickson. Nice step back there, and you're seeing why on a move like that. That's not something that's often in the repertoire of a lot of high school juniors, but as we know, he's one of the better guards in the state. Has offers from a lot of teams, including Oklahoma State, OU, Tulsa, Iowa, Creighton, Purdue, Missouri, Virginia Tech, and others.
That's going to be an air ball on the second free throw.
I'd like to see the Tigers find a way to get Connor Dow some more looks right now.
Good defense by Howell. Howell jams it in there. And that'll tie the game. That could be a momentum booster here for the Tigers.
That is also a great look. You can get more steals and force turnovers and get dunks, you're getting good looks.
With it is Holly. Finds Driver in the corner. Ellison guarding, that's a mismatch. Holly with it. He loses it. Picked up by Dow, but it's going to be a foul. I think it's going to be a charge there by Justice Sutton. That'll be Broken Arrow ball.
Good defensive effort there by the Tigers. I particularly like the closeout by Ethan Ellison, forcing that drive and then the help into the paint. Force that turnover.
With it is David Howe. Guarding him is Tristan Driver. He finds Justice Sutton. Gets it into Dayson Cook, who finds Howe again. Howe goes up with a nice little fillet-type layup. He's going to be fouled.
Tigers definitely running a set play out of there, trying to get Howe an easy look. If he takes one more dribble and goes up a little stronger, he's at least got an easy two or an and one. Tried a little higher degree of difficulty
shot
there.
Tried to make it look flashy.
But, yeah. Hopefully he can get the two free throws.
His first free throw is good.
Well, and he has not been to the free throw line very much this year. Coming in the game, just one free throw on the season, so now he's 2-for-2. Make it 2-for-3.
With it is Nick Fredrickson. Finds Holly, and Tigers run a little bit of a full court press here, and it's going to work to their favor. Ethan Ellison with it. Finds it side to Justice Sutton. Sutton
goes up. It's good defense there by the Bixby Spartans.
Tigers going to be fortunate there as that ball went out of bounds off Bixby, but a big missed opportunity off that turnover. Kind of didn't have good separation between a couple of the guys and forced it into a bad shot.
Howell with it. Gets it inside to Ellison, but it's going to be tipped away. Parker Fredrickson with it. It's going to be a foul call there on Justice Sutton. That'll send Parker Fredrickson to the line, I believe, or yeah. Or no. It's going to be inbounded. Or no, it is free throws. Guess the Bixby Spartans are in the bonus now. Fredrickson only 2 points so far here tonight. Make that three. Looking to make it four. As you said, Tigers are definitely shutting him down here tonight, but a lot of other players are stepping up in place of him. And the ball gets stuck in the – that is weird.
Well, we know we got a new court. Maybe we got some new nets too.
Howell setting up the offense here. Gets it to Dow. Howell is going to be fouled there. That'll send him to the line for two.
Bringing out the Euro step there. Might have got away with a walk, but the refs didn't see so, so he's going to go back to the line again. Like seeing him get to the line more. Like I said, he's not done it a lot this year, but with his size and athleticism, he's definitely a guy that should be at the line more.
He's going to miss that first free throw there. Anthony Allen's going to be checked back in as well as Aaron Johnson in place of Jason Cook and Justice Sutton. And our starters are back in here for the Broken Arrow Tigers. Second free throw for Howell is good. That'll make it a one-point lead. Good pass there from Parker Fredrickson to Driver. And it gets it to McCrary. McCrary is going to be fouled by Connor Dow. That'll send him to the line. Battle of the free throws here so far in the second quarter.
Yeah, and it's kind of – you're kind of seeing, you know, the game gets a little sluggish when so many fouls start getting called. So hopefully we can get out of – this is the same situation we were in the last home game that we did before the break where it just turned into a free throw shooting contest.
And that one will be tipped away by Connor Dow, and that'll be Bixby ball. Holly to inbounded here for the Spartans. Finds Nick Fredrickson, and it's going to be a double dribble there. And that'll be another turnover here for Bixby. Inbounds it to DJ Howell. Finds Ethan Ellison at the top of the key. Aaron Johnson with it now. David Howell. Screen set by Allen to Dow. Dow's going to lose it there. Good defense by Parker Fredrickson. Goes up with a nice little Euro step. Fouled there by Anthony Allen. It's another foul for the Tigers.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of touchy fouls right now on both ends. You know, 5 minutes to the quarter, and we've got 17 fouls called. So Tigers 20, Bixby 19, fouls 17.
It'll be two free throws here. Misses the first. Caleb Nibelink's going to go in for Connor Dow. Fredrickson looking to make it five for himself here tonight. He's not able to. Anthony Allen with the rebound. And the Tigers are going to choose to slow it down as Aaron Johnson takes it up the floor.
I think this is about the fifth different defense we've seen Bixby in so far tonight. They continue to junk it up.
Nibbling for three from the corner, no good. Rebound McCrary. McCrary to Holly. Good pass there to Driver for three. It's good! Almost a foul called there as he fell down.
Anthony Allen, good defense by Nick Fredrickson, but it's going to be a foul called there. So he practically pushes Anthony Allen to the floor. That'll send Anthony Allen to the line.
Yeah, again, Bixby, just doesn't matter who it is, they seem to have the green light. It's a, it's an interesting team to watch because you got, you know, a D1 recruit, and then you got a lot of just similar pieces that all seem to play hard and seem to be interchangeable. And right now, you know, Parker's teammates are really stepping up and helping him out a lot.
And Jonah Sherman's going to check in here for Bixby in place of Nick Fredrickson. First free throw is no good there for Anthony Allen. Tigers not converting well here so far tonight at the free throw line, but Aaron Johnson with an immediate takeaway goes up, and it's going to be an and one there for Aaron Johnson. Definitely a good shot there, a momentum shifter possibly here for the Tigers. Yeah. He'll look to convert it.
Aaron with another bucket, having a good night so far, going to the line trying to get the and one. We'd spotlighted him earlier in the game as a guy that would have a chance to step up for the Tigers tonight, and he's already at a season average. I think he averages a little over 7 points a game, typically known as a more of a glue guy, but tonight has a chance to put some points on the board.
Well, he is currently our leading scorer with 8 points here on the night. Now there's Parker Fredrickson as they double him. They find Driver. Driver to Holly. Holly goes up. Nice little layup there for Holly. That'll make it a one-point lead here for Bixby. Aaron Johnson finds Anthony Allen, gets it inside to Nibelink. Nibelink losing it there, finds Ethan Ellison. Aaron Johnson, and he's going to be fouled there. Or he's going to be pushed out. Sorry, excuse me. That'll be broken arrow ball.
Yeah, Bixby continues to rotate well defensively. Doesn't really matter what they're doing. They seem to be flying towards the ball, helping. Really impressed with their team defense.
Well, it's going to be the 11th different man here for Bixby here so far tonight as Nick Elliott goes in place of Connor McCrary. Or Cam McCrary. I keep messing his name up. Anthony Allen with it for a nice mid-range shot. No good. It's going to be rebounded by Holly. Holly loses it for a second, but it's going to be picked up by Sermon. Sermon to Driver for three. It's good there for Nick. For Driver. Tristan Driver.
And back to the free throw line.
Yep.
Well, Tristan Driver's feeling it right now. That kid has been fun to watch so far. He's one of the smaller guys on the court, probably the smallest, but he is showing no fear out there, both on the defensive end and letting it fly on offense.
That was a cold three-pointer from him there, too. Just had complete confidence. Didn't even follow through.
He's a freshman, too.
Wow.
5'9 freshman.
A lot of potential there. Ellison misses his first free throw. And he'll miss the second. Looking like a common theme here for the Tigers. Parker Fredrickson finds Holly. Holly goes up, and it's good there as he shoots it over Nibelink and Anthony Allen. Good pass there from Howell. He gets it back into Howell. Howell with a hop step. He's going to lose it. It's going to go out of bounds, but it will retain. Broken arrow ball, remain broken arrow ball. And Dasa Cook's going to check in for the Tigers, and Nick Fredrickson will check in for Spartans as well as Sean Page.
Well, largest deficit of the night for Broken Arrow, down six right now. They need a bucket.
Anthony Allen with it. Passes out to Ellison. Ellison goes up, and it's going to be a foul there, a late call. It's going to be a foul by, I believe, Sean Page. Or no, sorry. It's going to be called down Parker Fredrickson. Look to see if Ellison can make these free throws here as he does the first. Tigers definitely want to turn that around here. Free throw game has not been very strong tonight. A lot of missed chances. Thank you. right, Tristan Driver's going to go back in here for Bixby. The second free throw is no good there for Ellison, and it'll remain Bixby ball. Just tipped out by Aaron Johnson. 24-29 here. A little over 3 minutes left in the first half. Tristan Driver with it.
So I got word from my man Wesley Richardson down the court that we had a couple numbers wrong on the official roster. Apparently number 20 is actually Miles Hill.
Oh, okay.
Not Nick Fredrickson. And number zero is Devin Isham, not Cam McCrary. So
Devin Isham and Miles Hill.
We apologize if anybody from Bixby was watching at home.
So I say three Fredricksons on the same team.
Yeah, apparently they don't. I'm a little confused about the Fredricksons. Four and five, though. Parker and Luke are twin brothers.
Well, Miles Hill is going to be fouled here, so he'll go to the line. A lot of petty fouls here so far from Broken Arrow tonight. Connor Dow is going to go to the scorer's table to check in. Student section getting loud here for Hill. His second free throw. His first, no good. Sermon goes in for Bixby. Connor Dow goes in.
Connor coming back into the game with two fouls and 0 points. He was on the bench for quite a while, so with 2.5 minutes, he's going to have to be careful on defense. But they're going to need him to step up on offense because they, like I said, scoreless so far tonight, and they need him to contribute.
Free throw from Hill. It's also no good. It's going to be rebounded by Sermon. Fredrickson for three. It's no good. But rebounded Hill. Hill's no good either. Rebound Aaron Johnson. It looks like it's going to be an over-the-back foul there. That'll be Broken Arrow ball. Or actually, no, they'll send Anthony Allen, I believe, to the free throw line. Or not Anthony Allen. Send the Tigers to the free throw line. And Aaron Johnson to take them.
Well, both teams now in the double bonus again.
That one's off the front of the rim.
So apparently, if me and you are on the call, we're going to see a lot of free throws. We're 2-for-2 now on the season.
Definitely not my personal favorite brand
of
basketball.
No, I would prefer them loosen up the calls a little bit, let them play. Definitely has slowed this pace of the game down.
Braden Johnson will go in for Aaron Johnson here. Dason Cook guarding Parker Fredrickson. Fredrickson with it, gets it inside to Sermon. Finds Holly. Fredrickson again with it, who gets it back to Holly. All the way to the other side to Driver. Driver for three. It's an air ball that time. Hill with the rebound. He's no good. Rebound Anthony Allen. Braden Johnson finds Connor Dow, who gets it to Ethan Ellison. He now finds Braden Johnson. It looks like the Tigers are going to set their offense up here. Finds Ethan Ellison. Ellison back to Braden Johnson. Johnson goes left. Gets it back to Ethan Ellison. Johnson once again with it. Goes up for a nice pull-up mid-range shot. No good. Rebound, Miles Hill. Parker Fredrickson with it now.
It was a good look by Braden there, but unable to knock it down. And just when your two main scoring guards have two fouls and no points with a minute till halftime, that's not what you're looking for.
Finds Cook on the inside. He's going to be fouled. Anthony Allen puts it back, but that's not going to count.
And again, just Tigers don't want that foul. You had the offensive rebound and a momentum builder. Instead, we get a touch call for another foul, sending Dason Cook to the line.
Nick Elliott is about to check in here for Bixby. Dason Cook, first free throw, is no good. The Tiger free throw struggles continue here tonight. Second free throw here for Dayson Cook. And it's also no good. Parker Fredrickson with it now, with a minute and 10 seconds remaining here in the first half. Scores 29-25, Bixby. Tristan Driver with it. Holly with a nice little fake, and he goes up. Finds Ethan Ellison. Braden Johnson slowing it down once again here. Anthony Allen with it. He's going to go inside. He's going to lose it there. Braden Johnson for three. It's no good. Rebound, Dayson Cook, though. Good effort there from Dayson Cook. Dow with it. Goes up with a little floater. No good. Rebound, Sherman. But he's taken by Ellison. Ellison goes up with the layup, and it's finally good there for the Tigers.
Much needed easy bucket there as the Tigers are working really hard to score right now, so you always like it when you can steal a couple points right there with 15 seconds left. Oh, my.
Driver. It's good there for Tristan Driver. What a game he's having.
That was absolutely a no-no, yes-yes shot by Driver.
And Dayson Cook misses it to end the first half. And Bixby's going to head into halftime, 34-27, having an absolutely amazing performance.
We'll see if we can get Madison to check with Coach Wallace right before half. Madison, we'll go to you here with Coach Wallace.
Coach, obviously down by a few points at half. What do you like from your team so far?
What do I like? I don't like very much right now. I just think we've missed a lot of easy free throws, and we haven't covered back on the other side.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thanks, Madison. So it's 34-27 at halftime as the Tigers in a free throw contest right now with Bixby as they hope to see if we can get a few things straightened out at halftime. I think we're going to see a much different Tiger team. We will go down to the court for the halftime performance here, and then we'll go to some commercials after this.
start it from the beginning for you.
Recently, you've had to put your life on hold, and we're with you in this. At Ascension St. John, we're now open for appointments, and we are fully prepared for your safety and our care. As we open our doors again, our doctors, nurses, and care teams will continue to wear personal protective equipment. we've taken even more steps to clean and stringently disinfect all areas. We will maintain distancing in our waiting rooms and will continue to limit visitors. And we will still screen all staff to protect their health and yours. Our emergency rooms are here 24/7. Please do not delay care. We're still delivering babies and performing surgeries. And we're open for your appointments, from specialists in surgical care to routine care and health screenings. Ask us about virtual visits. Ascension St. John continues to care for you, as we have been, for almost a century. Thank you for trusting us.
And we are back here for the start of the second half here between the Broken Arrow Tigers and the Bixby Spartans. The 34-27 lead here for Bixby so far. Definitely been a battle of the free throws in the first half. How can Broken Arrow improve on not fouling and also hitting their free throws?
Well, the flow of the game, like you said, we weren't able to get into a good flow there in that second quarter after a little bit of a, really in the whole half, to be honest. But the second quarter was especially ugly. And really the difference in the game is Bixby's hitting three-pointers. You know, Bixby's hit their free throws a little higher clip, and Broken Arrow has not shot well from three, and Bixby is having their secondary guys step up in a big way in the second quarter especially. So it will be interesting to see what adjustments Broken Arrow makes as they're down seven to start the third quarter.
Now, Parker Fredrickson only being held to 4 points in the first half, but you have shooters like Tristan Driver, penetrators like Holly.
Yeah, and I want to reiterate that we apparently there was some roster confusion. There's about five or six guys that have switched numbers from the roster that we were given for the program. So we apologize if you're from Bixby and you're watching at home if we mix up a guy, but we just got to go with what we got.
Connor Dowell almost losing it there. He picks it back up, finds Ellison. Nice pass there to Braden Johnson. Johnson out to Ellison. Ellison goes up. Oh, and it just rims out there. And Holly will get the rebound. Tristan Driver. He's been on fire here tonight. Isham with it, finds Parker Fredrickson. Fredrickson goes up. He's going to be fouled. And the fouling trouble continues here from Broken Arrow as we enter the second half.
Aaron Johnson with his second personal first team foul of this half.
Now send Fredrickson to the line for two.
Parker Fredrickson.
4 points, as I said earlier, for Parker Fredrickson, but he'll make it five, looking to make it six. You know, you gotta love the effort that Broken Arrow uses to stop players like Parker Fredrickson and David Castillo, but it's just these players on the team, along with them, love to step up all the time. But Dow shoots a nice three-pointer there. That'll make it 30-36. Just the first bucket of the first half. I mean, the second half here.
Not only that, the first 3 points of the night from Connor Dow. We talked about that late in the second quarter, that they really need him to get going, and hopefully he can have a big second half.
Driver's fifth three-pointer, no good there. Making him 3-for-5 on the night, and that's blocked by Anthony Allen. That's going to be rebounded there by Isham. Isham out to Driver. This one for three. It's good. 4-for-6 on the night here from Tristan Driver from three-point land, and they're all nice threes too. That'll go out of bounds. It'll be remaining with Broken Arrow.
Yeah, got to get those 50-50 balls. Anthony comes up with a big block. Ball gets loose. Tigers don't come up with it. It bounces around, and once again, Tristan Driver knocks down a big bucket.
Shifley is going to go out here for Surum. Aaron Johnson with it, finds Ethan Ellison. Anthony Allen now with it. Finds Dow. Dow for a deep three. It's good there from Connor Dow. A hand in his face, but it doesn't matter.
So in less than two minutes, Connor Dow goes from 0 to 6 points, but the Tigers still trail six. Got to start getting more stops on the defensive end.
Holly goes up. It's going to rim in there for him. Shooter's roll. Ellison with it, finds Allen. Allen goes up, but passes out to Dow. Dow goes in, backs into Allen. Allen, he misses the dunk.
And even if he was able to tip that in, it would not have counted.
Do not see that very often. Nice shot fake. You know, they got out there on Connor, made him put on the floor. He made the right play, and Anthony was unable to flush it down.
Driver with it. It's going to go out of bounds, tipped away by Ethan Ellison. That dunk right there could have been a huge momentum shifter. He's just not able to connect it. Really rare to see that from Anthony Allen. Shot from Fredrickson. It's good. Right in Aaron Johnson's face. That's going to make it an 11-point lead, the largest lead of the night here for Bixby. Dow tries to answer back with a three of his own, which he does. And that's going to be a timeout there from Coach Knight of Bixby.
Little surprised to see that timeout there. I mean, if you're Bixby, you're in control of this game. I think we're going to have a full timeout, so we will go to commercial. You're watching Aerovision. We'll be right back.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
And we are back here with a little bit over 5 minutes left here in the third quarter. 44-36 for Bixby over the Tigers. Lots of three-pointers here. It's a three-point barrage here in the third quarter. Spencer, how are you feeling about the Tigers' performance heading out of halftime?
Well, I think I love seeing Connor Dow come out and go 3-for-3 from three-point range to start it off, but we're not getting any stops right now. So until we start getting some stops on the defensive end, you know, we've taken a 7-point lead that stretched to 11, and now it's back to 8. But it's Bixby's ball, and the thing about Bixby right now is they're playing with a lot of confidence, and Coach Wallace has got to find a solution to get some more stops on the defensive end. The team's got to execute.
And we're going to really quickly send it down to Madison Dildine for some insight. Madison?
Yeah, guys, Coach Wallace was just telling his guys, you have to be solid right now and screen for the guy that's hot, guys.
Thank you very much, Madison. They find Allen. Allen with a breakaway dunk here from Allen.
He did not miss that one.
For sure. That'll make it 38-44 here now. Parker Fredrickson goes up. It's no good. Rebound, Braden Johnson. Braden Johnson almost losing it there. Oh, but he's going to get to Anthony Allen. Allen out to Braden Johnson. Goes up. No good. Tried tipping it in there from Allen, but it's not going to work. That'll be a rebound from Shifley. It's going to be a blocking foul there from Braden Johnson.
Braden's still looking for his first points of the night, unable to get him there. Instead, he's gone back, and now he's picked up his third foul. So we're going to see
DJ Howell
check back into the game.
Off night here for Braden Johnson. Coach is definitely going to want to get him more involved. Almost a travel there from Shifley, but it's not going to be called. Now with it is Howell. Finds Allen. Allen jams it down once again. 40-44, and the Tigers are starting to become in control.
And you're seeing some really nice transition offense. Running the floor, good spacing, running with purpose. Anthony filling the lane. And back-to-back dunks for Anthony.
Fredrickson goes up. It's going to be a foul there by Anthony Allen.
Yeah, you just got to be smarter. You know, you're bailing him out a little bit. He's going to have a tough shot regardless. Just go straight up and make him hit it.
And that's going to be Anthony Allen's third personal foul of the game here.
Yeah, we're going to definitely, you know, this quarter has gone by much faster than the second quarter. But the Tigers still have some guys with foul issues now with their second starter with three fouls due to that super sluggish, slow foul fest of a second quarter.
Fredrickson with this next free throw looking to put himself in the double digits here.
Yeah, we've seen him miss several free throws tonight.
Very uncharacteristic. Miles Hillis checked in here for Bixby. His second free throw is good. And
yeah, going to have another timeout here. See if we stay here or not. Back to a five-point game. Looks like we got a 30-second timeout, so we will stay here. Will be interesting to see what Coach Wallace does, how much longer he leaves Anthony Allen in the game with three fouls. Looks like he's going to stay out here right now, but wouldn't be surprised to see him get a little bit of a breather to end the third going into the fourth. But if you're Coach Wallace, you're really trying to make a run here to get that lead back going into the fourth, and they've got a little under 4 minutes to do so, down just five now. So BA now with a two-point lead here in this quarter after falling down 11 at one point.
And our scoring leaders, Anthony Allen and Connor Dow, definitely having a very good second half compared to the first. Got to hope they can keep that up.
Big possession here. Let's see if they have a set play out of a timeout here. No telling what kind of defense Bixby's going to throw at them.
Looks like they're running a 2-3 here. He's going to switch to man. Shot from Dow. Dow no good. Rebound, Holly.
Got a good look. Little deep there. Unable to knock it down.
Been saying Holly's name a lot here tonight on the rebounds. Hill goes up. No good. Rebound, Dow. Dow finds Ellison. Ellison goes up, and it's a good little finger roll there. And that's going to make it only a three-point game here.
Got to feel good if you're Broken Arrow right now. The amount of transition baskets you've been able to get here in the last few minutes. Anthony, a little risky there.
Almost
going
blocked.
Up for back-to-back blocks, and he got them both.
And Howell with it now. Finds Ellison. Ellison goes right. Goes up with his left. And it's good, and that makes it a one-point game here for Broken Arrow. Chipping away.
Big time drive there by Ethan Ellison.
This is a very important possession here for Bixby. Driver with it. Aaron Johnson guarding. He'll get it to Isham. He finds Fredrickson. Gets it into Holly. Holly dropping in a second, but picks it back up. And it's going to go to Broken Arrow as it goes out of bounds off Holly.
Now force another turnover. We've really seen out of the timeout two main things after that 11-point deficit that we've seen. We've seen much better defense, and we've seen the Tigers really pushing it under control and taking advantage of transition opportunities.
It's a very big possession here for Broken Arrow. Got to see what they can do. Howell with it. As he goes inside, a little flashy layup, but it's going to be rebounded by Allen. A lot of bounce there for that rebound.
Fortunate, you know, nice effort by Anthony, but playing with three fouls right now, he is
definitely could have been
a little dicey on a couple of these things here. He's been fortunate to not have them called against him as they're going back the other way.
Fast break finds Howell. Howell goes up with a reverse, and he misses the layup there. Howell being a little too flashy on the layups here.
Yeah, he's just got to be a little bit more fundamental. He's being a little lackadaisical on some of the attempts. Like to see him just use the athleticism, but use the strength and fundamentals and go up strong.
Looks like it's going to be a foul there on Fredrickson, I believe. Now Connor Dow to inbound it here.
It's going to be three fouls on Fredrickson.
Howell with it. Goes up. Hesitated a little bit, but it works out anyways. That's going to make a three-point lead here for the Tigers.
Quite a run since the 11-point deficit timeout by Broken Arrow. Coming all the way back now with a three-point lead.
Tristan Driver with it. He finds Isham. Isham is going to be fouled. Coach Wallace not very happy about that on the sideline.
That's just another example of picking up fouls when you really don't need to. You know, moving your not that you ever want a foul, but there are times when you want it. But when a guy's driving with no real purpose and you're not moving your feet and you're picking up cheap fouls, that's never what you want to see.
Fredrickson with it. Goes up for three. And it's good there from Parker Fredrickson. What a good shot. And it's going to be a timeout right away from Coach Knight.
And Bixby's not going to have any timeouts left in the fourth quarter. This is the third timeout of the quarter that he's just kind of called that's been a little surprising to me. Had had one timeout when they cut it from 11 to 8 that you had momentum. So some, if you're Broken Arrow's like, fine, we'll take the rest if you want to give it to us.
Broken Arrow's biggest lead of the night was 6 points. They're definitely trying to make that a bigger factor, no doubt. How can Broken Arrow improve on that, on the score?
Well, I mean, just keep doing what, you know, that was a tough shot that tied the game up, but you've done a nice job on Fredrickson. But like we said, keep getting those transition opportunities, but it's just going to start on defense, not letting them, those secondary guys, you know, if Fredrickson hits a shot like that, that's fine. You'll deal with it. You'll move on. You'll take the next possession. But it's leaving those other guys with those, you know, better opportunities, better scoring opportunities, and easier looks that we got to keep cutting out.
And that shot will make Parker Fredrickson the leading scorer here tonight for Bixby with 13 points.
And he's done it pretty quietly.
Aaron Johnson with it. Connor Shifley is in for Bixby here. Johnson loses it there. And we're going to get a jump ball here. And it will remain with Bixby.
With Broken Arrow.
Excuse me, Broken Arrow. I'm sorry about that.
This might be the first time we've seen number 15, Jonah Sermon, all night. 6'5 junior.
Oh, he's been in there a few times.
Hasn't he?
Yeah.
Shows what I know. They played so many guys, it's been tough to keep up with.
Johnson to Johnson. Finds Dow.
Oh,
Dow for
look.
Three. Yeah, it's no good, but it's rebounded by Anthony Allen. Looks like it's going to be a foul, though, on Bixby.
Nope.
Or no, on Broken Arrow. Miles Hill will go in here for Bixby.
That was on Bixby, yeah.
Oh, wow, okay. Anthony Allen passing it in.
Fourth foul on Connor Shifley.
Anthony Allen, nice little layup, backs down Parker Fredrickson.
Now, Fredrickson tried to pull the chair on him. Instead, he pulled it on himself.
Holly, fade away there. It's no good.
11 is McCormick. That's one of the guys that we've got switched here. McCormick is 11. Holly is – it's really confusing.
Really confusing.
Holly is actually 10.
Oh, okay. So Nick Elliott is number 11 then, or number 14.
It's tough to read my my notes of changes there.
I apologize to any Bixby fans watching. I'm calling him Holly all night. Allen for three. It's good from Allen to end the third quarter.
I was beginning to wonder if the Tigers had any clock awareness there. It didn't look like we were going to get a shot off. And right at the last second, Aaron Johnson finds Anthony Allen and extends that lead back up to 5 for the Tigers.
And after being down 7,
11, at one, 11 early in the third.
They now have a 5-point lead here, 53-48. We will be right back with more fourth quarter action after these messages.
Just a reminder, there will come a time when they can no longer share a bedroom. That's why we have a complete array of home loans so that dream of more space can come true. Right on time. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. The right balance.
And we are back here with the start of the fourth quarter. Your Tigers have a 53-48 lead over the Bixby Spartans. A dominant showcase from Connor Dow and Anthony Allen in the third quarter. What can Broken Arrow do to keep that momentum?
Well, I mean, I've reiterated it several times, but coming out of the timeout, 11, the Tigers have just gone on a run, and they just got to continue what they're doing. You're seeing them get good shots. You're seeing them play much better defense. Get the 50-50 balls. Take the easy shots when you get them. Finish them and stay out of foul trouble. Let's not have this fourth quarter look like the second quarter.
Ethan Ellison finds Howell. Dow with it. Anthony Allen. And that's going to be a travel there by Anthony Allen. That'll be a turnover there for Broken Arrow. Driver to inbound it here to McCormick. Or McCormick to inbound it to Driver.
been a while since we've seen Driver knock down a three. He was keeping him in that with that lead earlier.
Oh, and Fredrickson tries jamming it on Allen, but Allen says no, sir. Ooh. Aaron Johnson with it. Down for three. It's no good.
And we've got an Anthony Allen sprained ankle on the other end, and the refs did not blow the whistle initially. Came down wrong after that block shot. That is not what you want to see.
Not at all. Not from your star player. Well, Lizzie, I have a little injury break here. Spencer, broken arrow, doing pretty well. Connor Dow, definitely a huge factor here tonight. Does Broken Arrow really need to start finding Connor Dow a lot more often here in this fourth quarter?
Yeah, you know, he hit those three threes, and we haven't heard much from him in the last, you know, had a lot of Anthony Allen and Ethan Ellison there to finish the third quarter. I'd like to see Connor get to the basket some too, get to the free throw line. They're going to keep attacking him out on the perimeter as far as they can with his range, but I want to see him adjust to their defense and keep making things happen for his teammates or get to the free throw line.
That's good news there for Anthony Allen. He just walks off the court. No help needed.
Yeah, got a little bit of a limp. We'll see if we can get a report from Madison here in a little bit when she has a chance.
And that's going to be a travel there by Fredrickson.
Now, this is a big possession for Broken Arrow right now without Anthony on the floor. See what they can do with the minutes while he is away. And you kind of got Bixby on edge right now, up five and a lot of momentum. Let's see who steps up off the bench. We got Dayson Cook out there right now.
Braden Johnson with it. Finds Howell, makes his defender jump. Connor Dow with it. Braden Johnson. Connor Dow for three. It's good there from Connor Dow, 56-48.
Well, that was a very impressive possession by Connor Dow. He turned down a look, drove, kicked it, made a nice play, kept continuing, got another look, step back or step over, and made it happen. But the Bixby Spartans answer on the other end.
Fredrickson, that's going to be 15 points for him here on the night. Now if it is Howell. Connor Dow with it. Finds Dayson Cook, who gets it to DJ Howell. Braden Johnson loses Driver, who gets it to Howell. Howell goes up, and it's a good little layup there for him. Using the fundamentals on that one. Making it an 8-point lead here for the Tigers, the biggest one of the night. Fredrickson finds McCormick. McCormick goes up, and it's going to be a blocking foul there. Call on Connor Dow.
That's going to be four on Connor. So the two leading scorers for the Tigers in a little bit of foul trouble with 6 minutes left.
And McCormick will shoot two here.
Hey, Madison, if you get a chance, can you give us an injury update? It looks like Anthony Allen maybe just rolled the ankle but is going to be okay. Is that what it appears to you?
As right now, he's just drinking some more Gatorade and getting rolled out by our athletic trainer, but it seems like he will be good to go back into the game.
Good to hear. Looks like Anthony, you know, you always, a lot of times when you're playing basketball, whether it be a varsity game or just playing pickup, sometimes you roll that ankle. You're not sure if it was serious or not. It's a fine line between a sprained ankle and a rolled ankle, and it looks like Anthony may have avoided an injury here.
Howell finds Ellison. Cook begging for the ball, but it's a nice little finger roll there from Ellison. So he makes it 60-52.
14 points on the night from Ellison. It feels like he's hit every shot he's taken almost.
Rebound.
Great effort there by Ethan.
It's going to be a foul there, I believe, on Miles Hill. Not too sure. Ref having a word with Ethan Ellison there. Oh, it's a foul on Ethan Ellison.
Well, it's going to put three fouls on him.
A lot of boos coming from the crowd there.
Well, we got a good crowd tonight. The jungle is in full effect. It's jersey night. Who's got the best jersey that you've seen out there tonight? Who really brought their jersey game?
Saw Luka Doncic city jersey from last year.
77 down there.
Also saw some nice hockey jerseys. I like hockey jerseys. Nice and stylish.
few Laker jerseys as well.
Yeah, we got a few baseball jerseys, some Fernando Tatis.
Got an old school Oklahoma Sooners,
Baker Mayfield. Yeah.
Love to see it.
Baker Mayfield actually playing his last game of the season last night. Did not go to been an injury plague back half of the season for the Browns and Baker Mayfield. I read earlier he's going to undergo
Anthony
surgery.
Allen. Anthony Allen is back in the game here for the Tigers. The fans give him a little bit of an ovation here.
I also see a Milwaukee Brewers jersey. don't see those every on, but actually the girl wearing it, it's actually her uncle, Adrian Hauser, the Brewers. That is her uncle.
Wow, that's insane. Is Adrian Hauser an all-star?
He's not an all-star. He's a solid pitcher for the Brewers. He was in that same draft class with Broken Arrow's Archie Bradley and Owosso's Dylan Bundy.
It's going to be thrown out of bounds off of Anthony Allen's stomach. And it'll remain here with Bixby. 60-52. Nice pass there into Fredrickson, a little lob. That was nice.
Yeah, nice out of bounds play by Bixby to get an easy bucket there. Cut it back to six with a little over 5 minutes left.
Jason Cook finds Ellison. For the Tigers, you definitely want to slow it down here. A six-point lead. Definitely want to keep that, especially with foul trouble. Ethan Ellison finds Johnson. Johnson back to Ellison. It's going to be a timeout there for Broken Arrow. is the lead. Broken Arrow doing pretty well, but have to take a quick little break here for some more fourth quarter action. Sorry about that, guys.
Thought we had a 60, but we had a 30. False alarm.
Howell's inbounded here for the Tigers.
Big possession for Broken Arrow here with a little under five left. See what they got out of the timeout. Coach Wallace definitely has drawn up something. Seems to be a little confusion about what it is, or maybe it's changed due to Bixby's defensive look.
They get to Johnson. Johnson to Howell. Howell back to Johnson. Gives it to Ethan Ellison in the corner, who then finds DJ Howell once again. Jason Cook with it.
Love to see Braden knock down a three here.
Braden Johnson for three. It's no good, though. Rebounded by McCormick, who finds Miles Hill.
Had a good look at it, left it just a little short.
Fredrickson with it. Finds Driver. Driver for three. No good, and he's going to be fouled. That'll send him to the line for three here. So that'll be Dayson Cook's second foul of the game here. That is not a foul you want to give up. Chance for three.
No, and we've had a much better pace to the game here in the second half, but Broken Arrow has now put Bixby in the 1-1 the rest of the way, whereas Bixby just two fouls, which could come into effect here in the last minute or so if they're trailing. Would be interesting to see. May not be a bad idea for them to just pick up a couple fouls here and get closer to that free throw one, you know, bonus. Sometimes when you get down and you're trailing with a minute or two and you only got two or three fouls, it does not work out in your favor. But they're about to make this a three-point game.
Tristan Driver looking to make a 15 on the night for himself. And he will.
15 points on nothing but threes and free throws off of threes.
Howell with it. Finds Cook, who gets it to Braden Johnson. Braden Johnson goes inside a little bit. Passes inside to Ellison. Ellison's going to be fouled there.
Most of the Bixby cutting the lead from eight back to three has been with Connor Dow on the bench, so you'd like to see him get back in here pretty soon.
D. DJ Howell to pass it in here. Sermon's going to go in for Bixby in place of Miles Hill. Passing it in is Howell. He finds Dason Cook. Dason Cook back inside to DJ Howell. Howell goes up. Fouled. No good, though, on the and one. And he'll go to the line for two. Almost rolled in there a little bit there for DJ Howell.
Big free throws right here for DJ. We talked earlier about how he had only shot one free throw coming into the game. He's hit several tonight, and he knocks that one down.
Well, this next one, he's looking to enter double digits with 10 points. Which he will. Isham with it. Jason Cook guarding. Finds Tristan. Oh, he fakes it to Tristan Driver a little bit there, but Driver gets it for three. It's no good that time. Howell with the rebound. Finds Allen. Allen's going to lose it there. It's going to go out of bounds. And it will remain with Broken Arrows. His last touch by, I believe, McCormick.
Bixby did not like that call. Looked like that was last touch off the Tigers, but we will take it. Connor Dowd checked back in.
Connor Dowd's back into the game here for Dason Cook. And he'll be the one passing it in. Finds Braden Johnson. Dowd for an immediate three. No good. Rebound to Howell.
Great effort by DJ. Great effort.
It's going to be a foul there on Sermon.
There's really not too many shots, I would say, are a bad shot by Connor Dow. But that's one when you just come off the bench for a while, even though it was a decent look, wouldn't mind seeing you put that ball on the floor and continue to create, which he has done very well tonight, but kind of rushed that shot a little bit.
Braden Johnson with a fine towel. Howell to Dow. That's just a poor pass there from Ethan Ellison. Parker Fredrickson with it now. It's a name we've said a lot tonight. For three, it's good. Makes it 60-62 as the Bixby Spartans are chipping away here at this Broken Arrow lead.
6-point swing there by Broken Arrow is not what you want as you miss a three on one then, turn the ball over after a second chance, and then give up a big-time three by Fredrickson, who now has 20 on the night to lead all scorers after a mostly quiet first half.
Braden Johnson goes up. That's just a poor miss there from Johnson.
It looked like he got some body foul there by number 20, Miles Hill, but did not get the call. I think part of that was because of how he kind of went up one-handed on the layup.
With the decision. Big possession here for Bixby. Finds McCormick. Parker Fredrickson with it now. He goes up for three. It's no good. Rebound Anthony Allen. It's going to go. It looks like it's going to be a foul there on McCormick. Or sorry, Miles Hill. And Sermon's going to go in. Howell passes it in there to Braden Johnson. Tigers definitely want to slow it down here, but at the same time, this is a huge possession for them. Looking to make it a two-score game.
Aaron Johnson set to check back in at the next dead ball.
Ellison finds Braden Johnson. Braden Johnson for three. It's no good, but rebounded by Anthony Allen. Anthony Allen to Dow. Inside to Ellison, an easy layup there. He'll make it a 4-point game and a two-possession ball game.
Big offensive rebound in there, leading to a second chance basket, puts the Tigers back up four. Crucial defensive chance here. You got to come up with that loose ball, but they don't.
Now with it is McCormick. And it looks like Coach Knight's going to call a timeout.
Honestly surprised he has any left. It seems like he's used about five this half. And he does just have one left. And we have a full this time, so let's go to commercial probably for the last time tonight. You're watching Arrow Vision at 6460 Broken Arrow.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here.
We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
And we are back here, 64-60. Tigers with a 4-point lead with a minute and 45 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter. Spencer, what can the Tigers do to keep this lead?
Score and defend. Simple as that. You played a heck of a second half. You let Bixby on some tough shots here. Late creep back into it, but going to be a big possession here for the Tigers. It looks like Aaron Johnson is back in the game, and Braden Johnson is actually going to sit the bench and go with the hot hand of DJ Howe.
Passing to Shifley. Shifley with four fouls here. That's going to be taken by Howell. And Howell with a chance to make it a 6-point game. Oh, he's going to be fouled. Could have gotten the and one there.
Really impressed with the freshman tonight. He's got 10 points, chance to get 12, but it feels like he's left about 6 or 8 on the he's played well enough to have about a 20-point night, just not finishing around the basket. Something he will learn over time. You know, it's probably comes a lot easier to him when he's not playing varsity action.
And that first one is good. This one to make it a 6-point lead and a 12-point night for DJ Howell. And it's good. Minute 42 seconds remaining here. 66-60. Tigers are up. Parker Fredrickson with it. He goes left. Finds it to Isham. Driver for three. No good. Rebound McCormick. McCormick, no good. Taken by Aaron Johnson. Good steal. Now with this Howell. Dow for three. If this goes in, it's huge. And it does! Connor Dow makes it a 9-point game, the biggest lead of the night here for the Tigers with a minute and 10 seconds remaining.
Well, and a great loose ball picked up by Howell. He pushed it, found the shooter, and the Tigers may have finished this one.
Howell goes up, and it's good. An 11-point lead here, 57 seconds.
Now, the Tigers finishing this game the right way. The freshman's got 14 now.
That's a foul there on Ethan Ellison.
Double digits on that three by Dow, his fourth of the second half. Was that his fourth or fifth three of the second half? He's got 15, so I think, I can't remember if he had one in the first or not.
DJ Howell?
Connor.
Oh, yeah, I believe so. I haven't really seen him score any two-pointers here tonight.
Four guys in double figures right now for BA. 71-60 lead with 49 seconds, and Parker missed another free throw.
Shifley for three. It's no good. Rebound, Howell. And if you're Broken Arrow, you just want to slow it down here and end this one on a good note. Ethan Ellison gets it to Johnson.
Pull it out. Get it to Aaron. Well, Broken Arrow was down 11 about midway through the third quarter. They're now up 11, so a 22-point swing after that timeout. Coach Wallace has really got to be happy with it.
Great game here from the Tigers. They're just going to hold it down here to end this one as the crowd stands up and cheers. And chance.
Not sure who we're chanting overrated about. I guess Parker Fredrickson, but
assuming.
I'd be okay banning the overrated chant for everyone.
I don't really think that's overrated. A 20-point performance.
He did his job. The team did their job.
Broken
Arrow's an impressive. Impressive finish after a sluggish start by Broken Arrow as they go on to win 71-60. We'll get an interview with Coach Wallace and Madison Dildine here in a second. But, Ethan, tell me a little about your thoughts about that second half by the Tigers.
It was dominant for sure. Three-pointers were a huge, huge portion of that second half, especially by Connor Dow and other players. DJ Howell really stepping up, the freshman, doing very well in that second half as well. And Anthony Allen, a scary moment there, but he came back and did his job. after he sat out for a few minutes there. And it's a dominant win from the Tigers. Again, 71-60, an 11-point game. And if we can, get it down to Madison Dildine for an interview with Coach Wallace. Maddie?
Coach, right. You were down by 11 and then ended up winning by 22. What are your thoughts on tonight's game?
Did we win by 22? Wow. It's funny. Cool. I told the coaches that we'll win by 20 at halftime. I just thought we didn't compete the first half. And the second half, we came out. That team wanted to beat us. And our kids got to understand is when we're ranked like we are and everybody's talking about us, that we've got to show up every game. So I was proud of how they showed up.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, Madison.
You want to correct that? It was an 11-point win.
Yeah, it was
the
a 22-point swing. The Tigers were down 11 and finished winning 11, so a 22-point swing. And really, you know, out of that timeout, they just did everything right. They responded really well, finished strong, knocked down a lot of threes, had some big dunks in transition, but an impressive finish. The Tigers moved to 6-2 on the season, and we'll be back here on AeroVision with Tiger basketball here pretty soon. Next week, we are actually going to be doing girls wrestling. The next time we'll be doing Tiger basketball here at home will be the 18th on Sapulpa.
I'm Ethan Scott along with Greg Spencer, and we will see you guys next time. Thank you for joining us.